Hi guys! Do you want to know how to build your own or custom Armbian image for your device? You're in the right place. I'll show you how to do it step by step on my Orange Pi 5. And don't be afraid, you don't need to be a Linux pro or something like that. No. Wonderful people from the Armbian community made this so simple for us. It's almost like a one-liner. It's beautiful, baby. Let me show you.
First, what do we need? Few things. An ordinary 64-bit computer running Ubuntu Jemmy, the 22.04 version. As per Armbian documentation, this is the only officially supported environment. But don't worry, you don't need a separate computer for this. You can run it in Docker or in a virtual machine. I run it in VirtualBox and it works flawlessly. And you will need an SD card reader. That's basically everything you will need. As I stated, this will be a step-by-step tutorial, so let me show you how to prepare this build environment. Let's head over to virtualbox.org to download it. Hit the big download VirtualBox button and choose the platform. I'll pick Windows hosts as I'm doing this on Windows computer and save the file to downloads folder. And also download this VirtualBox extension pack. It adds some features to the VirtualBox you would like to have around. Okay, things are downloaded and now you just install VirtualBox the usual way. Double click the installation file and follow through with the process. It's basically next, next, next. You don't need to change anything here. Once it's installed, it will open. And as you can see, I've already got here a few virtual machines. That's of course because I use VirtualBox often and these machines I created some time ago. Your list of machines here will probably be empty. One more thing here, let's add the extension pack we've downloaded to the VirtualBox. Hit File, Tools, Extension Pack Manager and hit the installation button up here. Locate the downloaded extension pack. Select it and hit open and install. Scroll down and agree to the license agreement. Okay, so now we have the VirtualBox with the extension pack installed. We can check for updates, but as you can see, there is nothing to update right now. So, what's next? Now we need to download that Ubuntu Jemmy 22.04, which will be our building environment. Head over to ubuntu.com, download, and let's pick this desktop version. It's unnecessary to have a whole desktop environment for this, but for the sake of nice video, I'll do it for you. Let's wait a moment for the download to finish. Okay, it's done. Now we need to create a virtual machine using this downloaded image. Head over to VirtualBox, hit Machine, New, give it a name, let's say Armbian Builder. This location for the VM is fine for me. Just be sure to pick a location where you have at least 25 gigabytes of space. I recommend it to be something quick like SSD or NVMe drive, so it doesn't slow down the machine too much. Select the downloaded Ubuntu image. It will fill the type and version fields for you. And be sure to check this skip unattended installation. It doesn't work well. Hardware, we don't want this machine to be bogged down. Compilation takes a lot of time, so feel free to give it some horsepower. I'll give it 16 gigabytes of RAM and half of my CPU cores. And the hard disk, as I've said, you need at least 25 gigabytes of space. I'll give it the double, 50, just to be on the safe side. Don't worry, if you won't check this pre-allocate full size checkbox, it will only consume only as much space as it needs. Think of this number as of an upper limit for the virtual machine and hit finish. You can see the new machine over here. Let's check and adjust a few more things. Open the machine settings. Enable bidirectional shared clipboard so we can copy text between the host machine and this guest seamlessly. And we'll enable bidirectional drag and drop tool. System tab, here seems everything okay. Display, let's add more video memory to this machine. Storage, audio, network, here I want to have a bridge adapter so I can connect to this virtual machine via SSH, for example, from any device on my network. I don't want it to be hidden behind this host computer. And over here, I'll enable USB 3 support. That should be all, okay. So now I am confident I can start this machine. We can see the VirtualBox logo and here's the first menu. Pick try or install Ubuntu and wait. The launcher will automatically spawn this window asking us which language we want to use and if we want to try Ubuntu or install it. What we are going to do here is the most common installation of Ubuntu OS. Select keyboard layout, we'll be fine with the minimal installation, and I'll enable third-party software, just for sure, because we are using the desktop environment and I'm a little concerned about the graphics drivers. Sure, erase the disk and install Ubuntu, pick your location, this one is correct for me. Your name, I'll just put in Ubuntu, same for username and password, and login automatically, so I don't need to write the password again and again. Let me speed this up a little. Okay, installation is complete, and restart the virtual machine. Here press enter and the installation medium will be ejected automatically. Wait a while and here we are. Clean Ubuntu installation running in VirtualBox. Skip this Pro wizard and let's change the resolution so we can see something in here. Okay, it was pretty easy. What's next? The building of the Armbian image itself. So how do we do that? Let's go to the terminal, update the system to be sure everything is daisy fresh. Sudo apt update, sudo apt upgrade. Okay, clear the screen. So we will need git to get the source code. Sudo apt install git. Where will we download the source code to? Make dir armbian, cd armbian, clear the screen. Git clone depth 1, branch main, https github.com armbian build, cd build. And here, just run the compile sh script. This is such an awesome script. You don't need to do anything else. Just watch. /compile.sh. Read the first line. It already fixed my first mistake. I tried to run the script without sudo or root privileges, and the script resolved that for me. After that, it downloads and installs the needed packages for the build environment and launches the configuration tool for us. You can configure the kernel according to your needs. As this is a demo, I will not go through everything you can configure in the Linux kernel. That's somewhat overwhelming topic for most people in the world. So I'll pick do not change the kernel configuration. On the next screen, we can choose for which board we want the image to be built. As you can see, there are a lot of them. And this is the list of officially supported boards. You can access even more boards via this button. That will show you community supported boards, work in progress boards, and boards whose support has already ended. I'll scan through this and find my Orange Pi board. Choose a kernel. In fact, there is only one kernel named Legacy, so there is no choice here. Okay, choose a package base. Today in April 2023, there are three supported bases. Debian 12 Bookworm, Debian 11 Bullseye, and LTS Ubuntu Jemmy 2204. I'm excited about this new Bookworm, so I'll pick this one. And as I'm using my SBCs, including this Orange Pi 5, headlessly as servers, I won't need the desktop environment. The console will be enough and will save some resources. That's it. Now the build process will begin and you can go grab a coffee or watch some of my other videos because this will take some time. In this configuration, it took something like 20 minutes to create the image.
Let me use this moment to thank to all of my subscribers, supporters for the kind comments on my videos. You're the reason why I'm doing these videos. If you find these videos helpful, please leave a comment down below, like them and share them with your friends. That's how we can reach more people and help them. You're part of this and you're fantastic. Thank you.
Okay, what did the build script create and where is it? ls, ls output, ls output slash images. Excellent, here it is. Armbian blah 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 dot img. That's the image we just created and we want to burn that to an SD card and use that SD card in our Orange Pi 5. Or whatever board you did build the image for. So how do we do that? Well, you can attach an SD card reader to your host machine and mount it to this virtual machine by right-clicking on this USB icon. It should work, but man, that never worked for me. I mean, like not only right now, I mean like in years and years. Sometimes it works, granted, but 90% of the time there are some strange errors with this. Maybe it's my hardware, you might be more lucky or skilled than me. If it works for you, just go for it. I'm just sharing with you my experience and my frustration when working with the USB SD readers in VirtualBox. After mounting the USB SD reader to this virtual machine, you can copy this image to the SD card like this. Sudo dd input file path to the image. Output file is something like dev sdb, block size 4 megabytes, status progress, and wait for the burn process to finish. But I needed to solve this in another way. I chose to copy this image to my host computer and use Balena Etcher from there. So how do I copy this file to my host machine? I'll set up a shared folder, which I'll be able to access from this virtual machine and at the same time from my host computer. To do that, follow my steps. Clear the screen and go for devices, insert guest editions, CD image. You will see the CD up here as it will be auto mounted. Its contents are in folder slash media slash Ubuntu, CD VBox GS version, and run this VBox Linux editions.run. Of course, with sudo and wait. After it's successfully installed, you might observe a few changes in behavior. The most prominent one is that you can drag the VirtualBox window and it will automatically adjust the resolution to it. And the more important feature you can't see right now, but is much more important to us, is that we can set up the shared folder I was talking about a few moments ago. Go to Machine, Settings, Shared Folders, and hit this folder with green plus icon. Choose Folder Path. I'll just pick my Downloads folder on my host computer and choose mount point inside the virtual machine. I'll do something like slash media slash host dash share and check the auto mount option and make it permanent. Hit OK and OK and reboot the virtual machine. Sudo reboot. Okay, here we are. Launch terminal, ls slash media. We can see the host share. Ls media slash host share, sudo ls slash media slash host share. Here it is. You can see the contents of my downloads folder in this virtual machine. Let me show you the downloads folder just to prove to you it's the same. So the only thing we need to do here is to copy that Armbian image to this folder. Sudo cp Armbian build output images Armbian. Use the dub key to fill the rest of the file name. To slash media slash host dash share and press enter. It should be a relatively quick copy operation. And let us look in the downloads directory on the host machine. See the image here? Perfect. That's all we need from this virtual machine for now, so we can just shut it down. Sudo power off. From this point, it should be straightforward. Launch Balena Etcher or whatever tool you use to burn the SD images. Choose the image file, insert the SD card into the reader, choose the target or destination, and flash it. That's it. Take out the card, put it in your device, and run it. I think the most time-consuming thing here was to create the build environment and burn that image to an SD card. Creating the Armbian image for your device is so simple and quick today, it almost looks ridiculous. I'm so grateful to the people who invested their skills and time to put all of this together. Hats off to you guys.
Okay, that's all. I hope this tutorial helped you. If so, please leave a comment under the video. It means a lot to me. Thank you, and I'll see you next time. Bye.